Paymount 31, I had a question coming out of section 5.6, number 49. And here we were asked to find all sorts of traits for this rational function over here, w of x. So the traits that I typically have you find, right, we always start with the domain. We're going to look at y-intercepts, x-intercepts. We'll take a look at if there's any VAs, if there's any holes, and then we'll look at the end behavior. Eventually, we'll get to range, but I only do the range once I have the graph. So let's start with domain, which is where we should always start. And I've talked a bit about how there are always three domain issues in any math function that I give you. You got to look for fractions, radicals, and logarithms. And for this particular problem, we don't have any radicals and we don't have any logarithms, but I do have a fraction. So I need to go pay attention to where is the denominator zero. And when I do that for the domain, if you see down here, I'm starting to analyze the domain, I get x equaling negative 2 and 4. All right, so once I do that, my domain is now all real numbers except negative 2 and 4. So I throw out negative 2 and I throw out 4. Now, once you do that, anytime you have a domain issue, these will either be vertical asymptotes or holes. So every time you have a domain issue, it'll show up in one of these two traits. I'm not sure which until I look a little closer at the function. So let's go ahead and take care of, let me write down the domain here just so I have it, negative infinity to negative 2. And then we go negative 2 to 4 and then 4 to infinity. All right, and I'll come back to vertical asymptotes and holes. Let me get the intercepts right now. So the y-intercept always comes when x is 0. So if I do w of 0, I'm going to do this off to the side here. My numerator would have a negative 1, a positive 3, and a negative 5. My denominator would have a 2 squared and then a negative 4. So if we play this out a little bit, if I look at my numerator, I have positive 15, and then I have negative 16 on that denominator. So it looks like my y-intercept is 0 and then almost negative 1 as I'm looking at it. Now, for x-intercepts, these three kind of tie in together, all right? The x-intercepts, the VAs, and the holes. This, you find these when x-intercepts are when the numerator is 0, VAs are when the denominator is 0, and holes are when the numerator and denominator zero out at the same time. So let me go ahead and erase this little part up here about the three domain issues. And let's take a look at, let's take a look at our function and see what we can do here. So what I want to do is I want to set the numerator to 0, set the denominator to 0, and see if they have anything in common. Now we already set the denominator to 0. We got negative 2 and 4. When I set the numerator to 0, I'm looking at x minus 1 equaling 0, x plus 3 equaling 0, and x minus 5 equaling 0. So the three x values I get from that are 1, negative 3, and 5. And none of these, let me just use a different color here, none of these overlap with the two that I found from the denominator being 0. So what I mean by that is these are the versions of numerator only is 0, and these down here are the version of denominator only is 0. So there is no whole, right? I don't have anything common to the numerator and denominator. So I have three x-intercepts. I have one at 1, negative 3, and 5, right? And I want to write those up as ordered pairs. And I have two VAs at negative 2 and 4. And I'm going to write those up as lines. And then we got to figure out what the end behavior is. So let me go ahead, and now I'm going to erase my y-intercept work down here. And I want us to take a look. Actually, I'll erase most of this. I want us to just take a look here at the degree in the numerator and denominator. So what I mean by that is if I look at the lead terms, I have x times x times x. So basically, I have an x cubed up here. And then I have x squared times x, right? X squared times x. So that's basically like saying x cubed over x cubed. So the degree in my denominator is the same as the degree in my numerator. And when that's the case, I want to take the ratio of the lead coefficients. And let me change pen colors here. The lead coefficient here is 1 and 1. So what I'm looking at is I ultimately have a horizontal asymptote at y equals 1. All right, so that's a whole bunch of traits. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to cut these out and drag them down to my next screen so that we can reference them. So let me scooch all of this down. And here's where you see me just working through all of those traits. All right, all of the traits. And I want to paste this here so that we can see what I'm looking at. So my domain, all right, I got my domain. So let's take a look at the y-intercept. I'll change pen colors here. So if I look at my y-intercept at 0, negative 15, 16, there is my y-intercept on the graph, right? I had three x-intercepts. I had one at 1, 0. I had one at negative 3, 0. And I had a different one here at 5, 0. So I see the three x-intercepts. I also see my two vertical asymptotes. I see one at x equaling negative 2 and x equaling 4. Here is my horizontal asymptote. There are no holes. All right, so if I'm taking a look at that, that is my graph. Now keep in mind, I definitely would have plugged this into my Y1 and hit zoom 6 to graph it. But this is a basic outline of my graph. And if I wanted to get the range, because let's say we want to add that range, that'll be there on your final. So not on your final, on your midterm. So I see the arrows heading down. I start at negative infinity. So if we follow this, right, this goes all the way up and comes back down to that horizontal asymptote. So there's some kind of maximum here. And I could use my calculator and find that maximum. But really, and let me use a different highlighter here. This function goes from all the way down to all the way up, right? You see the up arrow here? So my range, just based on this middle piece, is from negative infinity to infinity. So these two side pieces here don't even add anything to the range because this middle piece is taking care of everything. All right, thanks so much, everyone. Bye.